on March 24th, Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced that the entire country will go under a 21-day complete lockdown to control the spread of coronavirus pandemic. The announcement came 2 days after India observed PM Modi's call for a 14-hour Janta curfew. Since then, everything in the country has been shut down except for some essential services. In his speech, PM Modi had mentioned that the lockdown will be a much stricter version of the Janta curfew. Moreover, the authorities in Delhi said that shops selling essential items would require curfew passes to operate during the lockdown. This has created confusion among the people whether India is under a curfew. Well, not really.
A curfew is a situation in which a person cannot move out of his home at all. Examples of a curfew include the curfew that was imposed in New Delhi after the assassination of Mrs. Gandhi in 1984, and different curfews which have been imposed during riots across the country at different times. Now, curfew is generally imposed under Section 144 of the CRPC, which empowers a magistrate to pass specific orders. In case a curfew has to be imposed on a larger area which goes beyond the jurisdiction of a magistrate, separate orders will have to be passed by different magistrates exercising jurisdiction over their area. An example of this would include the curfew that was imposed in the state of Jammu and Kashmir following the watering down of Article 370 in August last year. A lockdown, on the other hand, is a situation in which a person is prohibited from leaving an area. Now, this area could be as small as his house, it could be the city, the district, or the entire state. In this case, the lockdown orders which have been issued under provisions of the Epidemic Diseases Act of 1897 and the Disaster Management Act of 2005.
In a lockdown, essential services are available to the public under reasonable restrictions. It means you can go out to buy food items, groceries, milk and medicines. You can also visit banks and ATMs for financial transactions. But during a curfew, even essential items are not available and only emergency services like hospitals remain open. Interestingly, neither lockdown nor curfew is defined under Indian laws.
Non-compliance of an order under Section 144 of the CRPC is punishable under Section 188 of the IPC, which prescribes an imprisonment to 6 months. The same punishment is prescribed in case a person fails to comply with regulations under the Epidemic Diseases Act. Non-compliance of guidelines issued under the Disaster Management Act is punishable with imprisonment for up to 2 years.
Since India went under a lockdown, there have been several reports of police high-handedness. Police authorities have been accused of indulging in violence against citizens in a bid to ensure that people don't gather in public.
A lot of questions have arisen regarding the use of force by the police in order to implement these directions. Now, the guidelines which have been prescribed themselves are silent on the powers of the police. The police does have powers under Section 129(2) of the CRPC, which authorizes the police to use reasonable force in order to disperse an unlawful assembly of 5 or more people. Viewed thus, police lathi charging an individual citizen who is out on the street is an illegal act.